thought you all might begin your tour here.
Our new medical assistant Chris as well. He's going to be assisting us today. Thank you very much. Yes. All right. Very well. Have a great day, everybody. Take
care. I'm really excited to be a care promoter for a day and have the opportunity to actually experience and feel and truly understand what it is to be a care promoter.
When we bring the patients into the room, we grab the tablet, we touch the name of the patient. His initial is EM1. Okay. So
we have three patients in the waiting room already.
Yeah, but one is for Dr. Manzano, The other one is for Dr. Ochoa, and another one is Hala.
Okay.
So I have priority because I'm assigned with my doctor. I'm gonna bring my patient first, and I know everybody's gonna come right now.
So how do you know that's your patient?
Because the initial of the doctor, EM1. See?
The care promoter is the one that supports the doctor. They have their interaction with the patient. Most of the time, most of the doctor, the patient feel comfortable with care promoter, and the care promoter usually gets information from the patient that they're not willing actually to tell the doctor, maybe because they don't trust them that much or they're not confident enough. And usually the care promoter gets to that point and that trust level with the patient that, you know, that we need to tell them, oh, this patient diabetic, oh, I ate this last night, this is why my sugar's high, or whatever the case is. So the care promoter is very, very important for our success here and our patient's care.
So the value of Chris's visit today as a care promoter to our center, it's tremendous. First, it sends the right message to our team is that he's supporting their roles, their duties, and at the end of the day, I think that it's going to support whatever decisions are made in order to increase our services, our the VIP services that are provided to our patients. That's going to be tremendous.
Mind if I check your blood pressure?
See, doing a blood pressure without a stethoscope.
Yep.
That's good, doctor.
I don't even know where I put that. I'm glad I have a tablet now.
Care promoter position to my work is like in my right hand and half of the left hand. That's the person who delivers the care to my patient. That's the person who makes sure that I can do my work properly, correct, and in an efficient way.
The daughter of this patient, she just left the hospital.
Uh-huh, yesterday.
Yesterday.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and then the daughter called us.
To let us know she needs a walker and an oxygen.
Walker and oxygen.
Uh-huh.
So we have to order both of those things for her?
What surprises me most about the care promoter role is the number of things that a care promoter needs to keep track of at the same time. And, you know, it takes really remarkable people to do this job well.
We have to multitask and do a lot of things.
Clearly.
So we have to get all those reports for all those patients.
So you got to bring those patients back, get the phone calls, and then the third thing is you got to get all this documentation.
Uh-huh.
Good morning. My name is Chris. I'm calling from Chen Senior Medical Centers in Miami Lakes. I am Dr. Manzano's care promoter, and I just wanted to let you know that Dr. Manzano placed the order for the walker and for the oxygen.
A couple times, I kind of froze for a second because I really didn't know where to go next. I had to stop for a moment and think, and then she looked at me and she said, there's no time to think. Yeah, we got patients that are waiting for us. Oh, okay, I better get to work.
Lily, how's he doing so far?
He's a little bit slow. We need to move a little bit fast because the patients cannot wait. Remember, VIP. I tried to do VIP with my patients, but they don't wait.
We had three patients, but I could only take care of one.
In an hour.
No.
He needs to be a little bit more fast.
One an hour is not going to cut it.
He needs to know how I feel, my pain, my 15,000 miles a day here in the office. So he needs to feel it.
The top thing that I noticed today was a level of complexity and how much complexity there is in the different parts of a care promoter's job. If it were one thing and there was one area that was complex, those can be managed and those can be worked through and you get familiar with it and you're able to deliver great results. when it's two things, three things, four things, five things, six things, each additional layer with all that complexity makes it very difficult for someone like me to learn how to do this job. I mean, I have to admit, I left the center and they asked me the same question. Chris, what are the things that you would want to change? And my head was still spinning. And so I thought, wow, if my head is spinning, imagine all the other folks out there who are learning how to do this job, this brand new position that we've created here that is apparently the right, Dr. Manzano would say, the right hand and the left hand of the PCP. You know, how can they do the job effectively, and how long does it take for them to learn it? We have a lot of special people in this company that can do the job very well and are delivering great results. What I'd love to figure out is how do I reduce the complexity of the different pieces of that job so that way care promoters can spend more time with their patients.